Hey, good morning.
It's Steph.
I wanted to share with you today my journey of becoming a life coach. My journey's been a long journey. I feel like it's been inside of me to be a life coach, I guess, my entire life. Because I cannot remember a time in my life when I did not want to connect with people and talk to people, to love people. So as far as I can remember, I've loved hearing people's stories, being a place for them to feel heard, to feel loved, to feel understood. So ever since I was little, I would be that person that would want to be there for someone if they were feeling sad or happy, or they wanted to celebrate their successes or talk about their challenges, their barriers, the pain they were going through, whatever it was they were experiencing in their life. I wanted to be that person for them. I wanted to have the deep conversations. And so a lot of the times my friends, when we were little younger, we would go for walks and just talk about whatever was on our hearts and on our minds. And I've wanted to help hold people accountable for whatever it is they say they want to do. Like, are you doing that? Are you following up? What's getting in your way? Why aren't you accomplishing this? I know you said you wanted to. Did it change? If you still want to, why are you not there yet? What do we need to do to get you there? How can I be of help? How can I support you in this process? So that's just who I am innately. However, I never really realized that was something you could do as a career. Okay, so, and also I was very sick when I was young. I would be in the hospital all the time. And the nurses were always so sweet to me. And I thought, I want to be a nurse when I grow up. I want to help people and I want to be a nurse. I want to just be that loving person for other people. So then I did things to take me down that path, like shadowed at the hospital my senior year of high school. And then I went into the nursing program for college. And I realized that this wasn't the career for me, because there was a time when I went to visit my family back home, and my mom and stepdad owned an RV park. And during that time, when I was home visiting my mom, someone had passed in the RV park, and we were at the hospital with him, with the husband, when he found out that his wife had died. And it was so sad and so just devastating, and I just couldn't believe it. And hearing his story, and I was like, nope, I can't do this. I am too sensitive of a person. I would be so sad. When I came home at the end of the day, I would be so sad because I couldn't do anything to stop that lady from dying. Do you know what I mean? It just was a situation, a career that I think I would feel more sadness than I would have felt joy doing. I decided in between my freshman year and sophomore year of college, I needed to switch my major. And so I heard about health and human development with an emphasis on family science. And I was like, what is that? Tell me more. And the more I learned about it, the more I was like, yes, this is what I need to be doing. This is me. Yes, 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 yes. So I entered that program and loved every single class, every single minute of it. Couldn't get enough. And then I started working in the field right away. So then I started working and volunteering for the Voice Center, which was, you know, we'd go around and we would talk to classes about a sexual assault and what is sexual assault and what do you do if you are sexually assaulted. So then there was also like a hotline for survivors of sexual assault, or if somebody needed to call in for domestic violence. It was really powerful. And so the more I got into this field, then people would ask, well, why did you change from nursing to behavioral health? That seems really sad. Like, behavioral health seems really sad. Hearing about people's trauma, hearing their pain, hearing their stories that are really sad and full of suffering. How can you do that? That's so sad. And I was like, well, it is sad, but it's a different type of sad. So at that time, my response would be, well, when people are sick, there's not a lot of choice there. However, with our behavior, we can have choice. So even if we grew up in a horrific environment, or just there was a lot of pain, or maybe we felt unloved, something, there is choice in what we can do for our future. We can choose to learn skills that we didn't learn at that, or that weren't modeled to us, and we can learn them, and we can create a life that is fulfilling for us. If we are doing a behavior that is harmful to us and that is taking us further away from the life we want, we can learn skills to bring us closer to the life we want. And I was like, yes, 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 yes. And I know that because I lived it myself. I know that our choices impact our path. And I was like, But I had to learn skills. I had to put in an effort to learn and work on myself and learn to love myself and learn to be the same person for me as I was for my friends. You know, I had to learn all these different skills, what a healthy relationship was, what's not okay to accept in relationships with people or relationships to myself or relationships with food or my body. I had to learn those skills. And once I did, I saw my life change. I saw my relationship with the way I think change, the way I thought about myself, my mind, my mindset, all these things change. And I was like, wow, that's really incredible. And if I can learn these skills, other people can learn these skills. I see it every single day. The beautiful thing about anybody's story is, yes, everyone has sadness in their story. However, that sadness doesn't have to dictate your entire life. You can choose new skills. You can choose to do things differently. You can choose to keep what worked from your childhood, whatever worked that was really great, and whatever didn't work, you can throw out and learn new ways of doing things. So it's not as sad because you can make different choices. So I decided, great, I'm going to learn these skills. And I'm going to show them to people. I'm going to teach these skills to people. And they can either take them and use them, or they can take them and throw them out, right? And that was empowering and inspiring. And I couldn't get enough of it. And I've spent years, like 18 years, and I still can't get enough of it. I absolutely love how we can learn things and apply them and change our life. So I got my degree and health and human development with an emphasis in family science because I wanted to be a certified family life educator, which I am now. So after college, I did AmeriCorps. I moved to Hartford, Connecticut. I did AmeriCorps. I worked with at-risk youth, and they were incredible, brilliant youth, and I loved every single minute. One of my favorite jobs to this day. I've also worked with the family homeless shelter, and I've worked at Gold's Gym. I've sold life insurance. When I moved to Arizona, I've worked with families that were involved with child protective services, substance abuse, suicidal, homicidal. And then I did therapy for couples, for individuals, for families. So one of the hardest parts for me with coaching is that they tell you you have to pick like one group of people. You have to pick a niche to work with, right? And I'm like, ooh, that's so hard to do because I've worked with all these groups of people. And I've loved that experience, and I've learned something from every person I've worked with. And well, one thing I've learned is that personal development is not the same steps for every single person. You know, you start where that person is, and they're going to be different than this person, and they're all going to be starting at different places, and you start where they are, not where you think they need to start. So that's been pretty cool. And not every person is going to need the same tools or the same steps to get them to where they're going, you know? And that's what I also really like about life coaching is it's very, you know, it's kind of strategic. It's like putting in a plan, but it's also very different for each individual. So it's really neat to see how people kind of embrace the plan that they're creating for themselves and how it's bringing them towards the life they want, towards the goals they're setting for themselves. So it's a really, really beautiful process to watch and to see people beginning to feel more confident in who they are and embracing themselves. It's one of the greatest gifts to be a witness of. So anyway, after working in the field for a while, I did get my master's in marriage and family therapy. However, I left therapy for a couple reasons. One, because we move around a lot and it's really difficult to transfer your license from state to state. And another reason is because with therapy, I felt that I was missing some tools that I really wanted to use with people. So I also decided to add in life coaching, hypnosis, and holistic nutrition, because there would be times when I would be talking with a client and they would be sharing something with me. And I was like, oh my gosh, if they would change their nutrition a little bit, or if they moved their body, you know, if they went out and got some movement in and talked about what was going through, they would get progress much faster. However, those were outside of my scope to talk about, so I wasn't allowed to. So I was like, okay, coaching is a really great fit for me because we're not going to marinate in your problems. we're going to, sure, you can tell me the barriers in your life. Like, let's talk about the barriers and let's talk about how we're going to overcome those barriers so that you can get to the goals that you have set for yourself. So life coaching is definitely not therapy. So after working with all of these people, I realized there was a common theme that kept popping up, that it was always about a relationship. So whether it was a relationship with themselves, with others, with food, with their body, with their mind, with their spirit, whatever it was a relationship. And so I was like, okay, I am going to be a relationship coach. Now, a lot of times people think a relationship coach is just for an intimate partner. There are a lot of coaches out there that do focus just on the intimate relationship. However, I like to focus on all the relationships in your life because really, every relationship in your life is going to influence you and have an effect on you. And so if we can make them fulfilling, happy, satisfying, just really great relationships, that is going to influence your life and impact your life in a very positive way. And so the beautiful thing is you have a part to play in each of those relationships that you can control, that you have say over. What are you going to do? How can you make little shifts to make it so that that relationship is the best it can be from your end? And that, my friend, is super empowering and super exciting because when you start making little shifts, there's a ripple effect and it's going to go out and it's going to affect every other aspect of your life. Now, sometimes that can be hard because not everybody wants those ripple effects, right? When you start doing something positive for yourself, that does shift somebody else, but that's a whole nother topic. So my style of life coaching is I absolutely love working with people on their relationship, whatever relationship that is. It's also interesting because back in 2007, I had a friend who was doing life coaching and I was like, what? That's a thing? You can work with people one-on-one outside of an organization. Like I could have my own company where I'm a life coach and I could work with people on reaching their goals and use all these tools that I have in my little tool bag and I can help them and guide them and help hold them accountable and encourage them and help brainstorm with them and just show them these skills. That's incredible. Sign me up. Where do I sign up? But I couldn't figure out how to be a life coach at that point in time. I didn't know, is there a school for that? Like, how do you become a life coach? Eventually, now it's like a huge thing and everyone's a life coach. But a few years later, I finally figured it out. So here I am. I am a life coach. I am a relationship coach. And I truly love working with people, getting past their barriers, inspiring them, motivating them, holding them accountable. You know, sometimes it's hard to tell people what they don't necessarily want to hear, but need to hear so that they can get where they're trying to go, where they say they want to go, right? And so I guess I'd say my journey to being a life coach, a relationship coach, has been an incredible one. And every single piece of it, every part of the puzzle has mattered. But my passion is always the same. My heart is always in the same place. And that is to be a place for people to expand themselves and improve their relationships and embrace and love who they really are. Because as soon as you love yourself, the world opens up to you in such a different way. You know, and once we create the relationships we want, the relationship with yourself is the most important relationship you're going to have because that is going to influence every other relationship that's in your life. And it is one to take seriously and nourish. That life that you want and that you dream about, the type of relationships you want to have, that is possible for you. It may be more work than the guy next to you. It may be less than the guy on the other side, but that work is valuable because it gets you to where you want to go. And your journey doesn't need to look like anybody else's. It can look exactly like how your journey looks. And I just want you to know that at the end of the day, that goal you have in mind, that life you want for yourself, that love you want to feel, it's available to you. It's there for you. I would say my life coaching is more of the style of creating the relationships you want, including with yourself, versus getting you that mansion. If you're not feeling good about who you are inside, it doesn't matter if you're living in that mansion or anywhere else. you will still be there. You are who you're living with. So if you can get this right, then you can live anywhere and feel blissful. So being a life coach is basically the best career that I could ask for, because I get to do what I've always done and what I've always loved to do. Be that person to hear your story, to offer love, support, encouragement, brainstorm actionable steps to get through it, help hold you accountable after you make those action plans, and being the person who truly believes in you. You know, back when I was in high school, I heard that it only takes one person to believe in you to change your life. And I was like, wow, okay. So I decided I want to be that one person for other people until they could be that person for themselves. And that's what life coaching is to me. I get to be the person who believes in you, who's gonna support you, who's gonna hold you accountable, who's gonna be honest with you and creative, coming up with solutions with you so that you can get to that goal that you have your eyes on. So that's part of my journey. Thank you for being here. I hope you have a fantastic day. So remember to like, subscribe, and share something in the comments. I would love to hear more about you. Have you ever worked with a life coach? If you have, what was your experience? And if you haven't, what's stopping you? What gets in the way of you wanting to work with a life coach? Have an awesome day. I'll talk to you later. Bye.